In this lesson, you are going to learn how to determine if two lines intersect. Lines can be intersecting or non-intersecting. Intersecting lines can intersect in any way or any angle. There's a special type of intersecting lines that we call perpendicular that intersect at a right angle. And non-intersecting lines are just parallel lines. They go on and on forever and they don't ever cross or intersect. Parallel lines have a special property, and we can use this property to determine if lines intersect or not. Let's look at these two parallel lines. In particular, let's look at their slopes. Recall that the slope of a line is its rate of change, and can be calculated on a graph by using rise over run. Let's calculate the slope of the green line. I'm going to start at this point, and I'm going to go to this point here. Again, you can pick any two points. The slope of the green line, it goes up 1, 2, 3, so the rise is 3, and the run is 1. So since it's a line that goes up, it's a positive 3, so the slope of the green line is 3. Now let's calculate the slope of the blue line. Again, pick any two points. I'm going to pick this point here and this point here. If I do my rise, I go up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So my rise is 6. And my run is 1, 2. Again, it's going up, so it's positive, and 6 divided by 2 is 3. So you'll notice that parallel lines, lines that don't intersect, have the same slope. If we want to see if two lines intersect, let's just calculate their slopes. If their slopes are different, then they intersect. I'm going to explain this idea by looking at the following problem. What is the slope of a line that passes through 1, negative 5, and 3, 3? Just like we did with the graph, we're going to use a formula. The formula for calculating the slope of a graph is rise over run. When we want to find slope using two points, we're going to use y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Now again, these formulas are related. The rise is just the up and down, the y-axis, how much you change on the y-axis, which is y2 minus y1. And the run is how much you change left and right, which is the x-axis, which is x2 minus x1. So the first thing I want to do before I calculate the slope is I want to label my points. x1, y1 for the first coordinate point, and x2, y2 for the second coordinate point. Please be careful. The ones and the twos that are the subscripts are not exponents. It's just identifying that this is the x and y coordinate of the first point and the x and y coordinate of the second point. Now I'm going to plug into my formula. y2 minus y1, well that's 3 minus negative 5. Again, be careful. This is y2 minus y1. One of the biggest mistakes people make is they say 3 minus 5, but it's 3 minus negative 5. x2 minus x1 is 3 minus 1. My double negatives become positive, and I have 8 divided by 2, which is 4. So the slope of the line that passes through 1, negative 5, and 3, 3 is 4. We're going to use this idea when trying to see if two lines intersect. Let's see how this works in a problem. If line 1 passes through 1, negative 5, and 3, 3, and line 2 passes through negative 6, negative 2, and 4, 6, will line 1 and line 2 intersect? Remember that lines that don't intersect have the same slope. So if these lines have different slopes, then they intersect. We already calculated the slope of line 1. It was 4. Now let's calculate the slope of line 2. Again, I'm going to label my points x1, y1. x2, y2. I always use my formula, and I always use it by actually writing it out first. So I'm going to write it out, and now I'm going to plug in 6 minus negative 2 divided by 4 minus negative 6. Here I have two double negatives, so I'm going to make those positive. And I have 8 divided by 10, which reduces to 4/5. So the slope of line 1 is 4, and the slope of line 2 is 4/5. These are different, so yes, they do intersect. So now you know how to determine if two lines intersect when given two pairs of coordinate points.